Hey there everyone, I'm Chris. I'm going to be doing a nice simple video today. I'm going to cover some reloading techniques with probably the most common type of weapon you're ever going to see out there on a skirmish field, and that is a M4 variant or AR-15 variant AEG. Not gas powered, not electric blowback, anything like that. Previously I did a video covering reload techniques with a GBB M4. A lot of the same stuff's going to apply here. Obviously this is going to be simpler, there's less steps involved, there's no bolt to be worrying about, nothing like that. It's just mag in, mag out. But there are certain aspects that I think a lot of people tend to miss out on. And now obviously the advantage of it being a more simpler type of weapon is that I can cover a few different styles with in terms of the reload. Whereas with the GBB rifle, you've got to be worrying about your checking inside the chamber and hitting the bolt release and stuff like that, and using the cocking handle and the bolt catch, etc. None of that with an AEG. But like I said, the video I did before with regards to gas blowback weapons pretty much only covered one method of reloading, and it's only airsoft, so you know, as long as you're set fairly efficient, the worst thing that's going to happen to you is you'll get shot with a few more bees. But you know what, there isn't just one way of doing things. So what we're going to do today, we're going to look at a couple of slightly different variations of things. So first off, we've got a standard M4 type AEG. This is my classic army M4 that I bought back in 2006. Obviously, this thing's ancient. I haven't skirmished it in a long time. Magazines wise, got some nice cheap mag brand 100 round mid caps. These are good, very sturdy, which is a handy thing with them. Nice and reliable, simple to use. Got a few, two different actually types of magazine pouches. I've got some shingles on the front of my plate carrier here, and some standard M4, double M4 type mag pouches on the side. These are the pouches that probably you'll see most commonly used and sold. Now when it comes to your kit choice, that is quite an important thing. What you see a lot of people doing is they'll be running pouches like these, but they'll be having the lids closed over the top of the mags. Now depending on where you're playing, say you're in a really sandy or really muddy type site, then you probably want that, because you want to keep the sand and the mud off your mags. Fine. But if you don't really need that, then that having to do that every time really slows you down. Now one of the first tips I would give anyone that's running these type of pouches, and there's probably a lot of you, is just take the lid and just flip it around and push it inside the pouch like so. What you'll notice is the pouches have got this elastic on the side. Now by putting the lid inside, it narrows the pouch itself, and when you put the mag in, the elastic holds it tight. It's never going to fall out of there. Even with a heavy metal mid cap or with a metal high cap full of BBs, that's not going anywhere. And that really speeds up your reloads, because you just grab the mag straight out. And you know, it's not like you're having to buy more shingle pouches instead. These do just as good a job as a shingle would, or any of the other Gucci mag pouches that are out there. And they're, like I said, they're commonly available for not much money. You can pick up some Pantac or Fly ones or whatever one like that, and they work nice and simple. So yeah, setting up your gear is important, but we'll cover that another time. Right, so let's get into the meat and potatoes. And you're in the game and you're skirmishing away, and you notice your mag runs dry. You fire a couple more shots and you're like, yep, definitely an empty mag. There's no point flicking it over and looking at that side, because you're not going to see anything, of course. Now, the first consideration to be taken in mind is, where is the empty mag going to be going? Now, there's three main things, or there's three main options that people tend to use. One, it's going to go back in the pouch it came from. Two, it's going to go in a dump pouch. Or three, it's going on the floor. Now, the problem with option one, putting the back in the pouch is where it came from, it's not that fast, especially if you've still got the lids over the top of the mags closed. You've got to open that up, put the mag in, and then close it again. It's a pretty slow procedure. Even with shingle pouches like this, they tend to be quite tight around the mag. So especially when they're new, you've got to get it in at just the right angle and slot it in to get it to go back in the pouch. So obviously it's secure and you're retaining the magazines, which is important, but not the quickest. Next option, dump pouch. Now, dark side, I quite see it from here, but I've got a standard sort of roll-up dump pouch just on my belt right there. This for me, this is what I use normally during a skirmish. I think they're ideal because it's a lot quicker to just dump the mag in there than it is to put it back in the pouch. And you're not having to drop them on the floor, which means mags aren't getting full of sand by water. You're not potentially losing them, forgetting where they are. Raking them obviously is a big thing, depending on the sort of mags you use. And I think it's the ideal compromise, really, because it's just mag out, straight in the pouch, done, and it's gone. Focus on getting it. Yeah, it's really that simple. They don't cost a whole lot. They just go right on your belt or on your rig. Pretty ideal solution. And third option, like I say, it's gone. When you really want to be super fast, it's just dump the mag on the floor. Now, there's obviously, you've got a couple of methods of doing that. You can just press your mag catch, and it drops straight out. Or you, if you really want to get it out there fast, you can flick it, and that will get the mags out of the rifle super quick. But as I mentioned before, disadvantages with that, you're dumping the mags on the floor, they might break, you might lose them, they might get full of mud and crap, and you're going to have to clean them. So it depends where you are, where exactly you're standing at the moment when it comes to doing the reload, various things like that. Just a personal decision for you, mate. Personally, I think it's best to just go with a dump pouch. If you're running an absolute crap load of magazines, might be a problem, or maybe you'll have to run two dump pouches. This, you know, it's just something you, like I said, you'll need to decide for yourself. So we'll start off, we'll cover a couple of the basics. Now, I'd recommend anyone who's not seen it to watch my GBB M4 mag reload video, or reload technique video. I'll put a link to it. I think I'll just put one up there. I'll put a little annotation, because that covers a lot of the same stuff as what I'm going to go through here. That gives you sort of your grounding and your foundation. Let's say we're in the game, and going back to before, we've gone to that same situation, but the mag has run dry in. I'll start off with option number one, and we're going to be putting the empty mag back into the pouch and our vest, because the particular rig we're running doesn't have a dump pouch. First thing to do is, when you've noticed your mags run dry, is to get the weapon up nice and high, up in front of your field of view, so you're keeping an eye out on everything that's going on. As you're coming up, your finger goes onto the mag release, good strong grip on the magazine, and it comes out. Now, at this point, obviously, you're going to have to look. You might have a pouch lid to open, something like that, and then magazine goes back in your pouch. Try and keep your eyes up as much as you can. Depends how good your muscle memory is, how much you've practiced, obviously. Mine isn't that great. So I'm going to have to look down here. I'll grab my mag pull that I have on this magazine, pull it out, straight in, and there we go. We're back in with a fresh mag. Disadvantage of that, not terribly fast with having to get that magazine back in the pouch, especially if, like I mentioned, you've got a Velcro lid to undo, or even worse, a quick release buckle or a press start, anything like that. You're going to have to open it up, put that mag in there, and then you're going to need to secure it down again. But it's not life or death, it can work. This time, different situation, your mag run has a, you're firing away and your mag run's dry again. Straight up here, again, really reinforce keeping that view upwards, so you're always looking around, scanning, seeing what's going on, because if you've got a pistol on you or a secondary weapon, then if a target's, some guy just pops up just 5 meters away from you, you can switch and you can take him out. Whereas if you're down here and you're doing your reload like this, you're not going to see this guy over here because you're looking at a floor. Avoid that one, guys. So, right, weapon's gone up, and we're option number two, which is dump pouch, which, again, I apologise, I couldn't quite fit it in the camera angle, but it's just out there. So, weapon's up, mag comes out, goes straight away in there. It's just a case of practising a few times, just remembering where it is in relation to your body, in your arm, etc., where it is on your belt. You just drop it straight in there, go for your new one, in, and you fire it. Overall, I think that's a... I think that's the best compromise in a skirmish, because you're not having to dump mags on the floor. Although that method is fast, it's got the issues of the dirt and breakage and losses, etc., like I mentioned. You're not having to do that, but you're not having to put mags back into the pouches that they came from, because that's slow. So, dump that one in the dump out. Let's say this time, let's say we're in an indoor environment, so it's a, maybe it's a very small, just you're just in a warehouse CQB game, small site. It's nice, nice clean concrete floor. You're running some nice light plastic caps like these. Now, the good thing about these mag brand ones is not only are they cheap, but they're just pretty much a solid lump of plastic. You know, I've got no issues at all about dropping these on the floor, even on a concrete floor, especially if you've got mag balls on. Chances are they're probably going to land that way up. So they're going to be fine if you drop them. So yeah, we're playing away in our CQB game. Fighting. Mag runs dry straight away. Mag catch. Can either grab it. Now this is going to vary between the brand of mag you use and the brand of weapon you use. Like there, for example, when I pressed the mag catch, it didn't drop out. I had to grab it with my hand and throw it out. Some weapons and some brands of magazines, you can just press that button there. It'll just fall out straight forward. You don't have to do anything. Now, sometimes when you have that problem, where the mags are a fairly snug fit in the mag well and they're not going to want to drop themselves, the good thing is if you just tilt the weapon either left or right, it's really your choice. Depends where you want to sling the mag, but let's say I'm going to start by tilting it to the right because I've got a clear space over here. I'll just press my mag catch and it's not worked. Oh, now it has. just goes to show you that really does depend on the brand of mag you're using. Let's try a different one. Let's go for it. So we'll try it this way. That's got rid of it. That's not always going to work. As you can see, sometimes you just get that bit of friction inside the magwell and they won't want to go, and you just have to grab it and get rid of it yourself. Sometimes just pressing the mag release won't do it, and even flicking them won't do it. So you've done that. You've done the flick, weapons come up, you've grabbed your fresh mag, goes in, firing. And obviously, try to be as smooth, sort of quick, but smooth is the key here, because if you fluff it, you'll probably end up taking longer than if you just went a bit slower. If you make a mistake, there's a higher chance that you're gonna, the overall time to do the reload will be greater than if you just plugged it through it slightly more methodically, a little bit slower. Because if you start panicking, you're like, oh, I've got to get this mag out, and then you've missed it. Depends how much practice you've done and stuff, but if your adrenaline's going and you're in a close quarters game and there's a lot of BBs flying around, just maybe take your time a little bit. Just pick up one of these here.